Basically, the main agenda of this presentation is that the various types of technologies that we have available at IIT Bombay for the distance education. I know you people are been aware about from last 2 days, basically focusing on the EduSat and the satellite based VSAT connectivity and interactive transmission. But CDEEP at IIT Bombay basically works for various technologies which is apart from satellite technology. As Fatak sir has mentioned in earlier session, we have got a web based technologies also. So here in this small presentation, I will try to make you people aware about the different type of technologies that we are using at the CDEEP IIT Bombay, keeping focal point on the web based technology. Now this is a small umbrella of various technologies those are available at CDEEP. You can see we have started with the live webcast, then video on demand, then learning management system we provide. Then the CD DVDs are available, what we get archived and recorded. Then we stream our courses through the Esclave TV channel also, and the content from the IIT Bombay are also available from the YouTube. Whereas EduSat is our one of the oldest possible technology for the distance participant. We will take few technologies one by one and try to cover the different umbrella available at IIT Bombay. Now live webcast. So what exactly live webcast is? IIT Bombay has started webcasting free live webcast courses from 2nd January 2008. Now live webcast courses enable student to participate in the IIT Bombay courses as individuals. Now what exactly the live webcast is that? We have found there is some limitation with the satellite based technology. As satellite has got only one channel, this is the satellite enabled studio we have, studio cum classroom. Where from we have started transmitting, but the limit was that at max we can transmit as good as 10 number of courses per semester. So if we want to scale the model, we want more and more channel. Now the cost of the transponder on the satellite, the maintenance cost, the uplink, the bandwidth and other thing, it is very difficult to cope up with the number of courses available at IIT Bombay. We have got around 500 courses per semester in IIT Bombay. Now to match up with the demand and the supply, the people who want the services and the type of different courses we have available, we were in search of some technology which can cater to the requirement available at this point of time. So we found web to be a good tool which can be used, wherein we are streaming the actual live classrooms to the world. I am using the word. Because there are certain limitations with the satellite that we will see later on, but with the webcast it is possible to reach out to everybody who is interested to listen to the IIT Bombay lecture. Any individual can access the live courses from anywhere across the globe through the browser. Now what you required for accessing the webcast or the web based courses is listed here. The internet connected PC what you required. With 100 kbps of bandwidth, we have tried to find out such a common minimum requirement of an individual that can be catered to the internet. Because streaming the video on the internet is a very difficult part, because the amount of bandwidth that is required for the recipient naturally is very high if you are streaming the video. So we have come up with the solution which can provide a reasonably good quality of video at 100 kbps. Now why 100 kbps? The reason 100 kbps is that whatever connection available at the recipient, just take for example a broadband connection or a dial-up connection with 128 kbps bandwidth, can cater to the 100 kbps of video. So if you have got a simple dial-up connection, or if you have got a broadband connection of 128 kbps, you can easily access our courses. Next thing which is required is the Windows operating system with the standard browser, maybe Firefox, Mozilla or Internet Explorer. It is also possible that you can access our courses through the Macintosh operating system using VLC player or on the Linux machine using the M player. So by this way we have tried to achieve the global reach, not only the regional or local, but the global reach to cater our courses across the globe. Now if we consider this streaming, what we are doing on the live basis is the time bound. Whenever the class is happening, that is being streamed and you can see it. Now there was a question that suppose some working professional want to see the course, suppose somebody is sitting in their own institute but having some different schedule at that point, cannot take to the course, because it is not possible that our timings and their timings always being synced. So we have a need to find out some solution that can cater to the offline streaming also. It may happen that we should give the flexibility of the recipient to see the courses whenever he has got a time. So we come up with the solution what we call as a video on demand VOD solution. If a student is not able to view the live webcast, but he can access it offline also using the video on demand service. The archived video is streamed on demand to the viewer, and there can be n number of simultaneous concurrent viewers. This video on demand service is different than the video on demand service that has been catered by these direct to home operator like Dish TV or Tata. These people say that you have to join the film at this and this time, and then the film will end at this and this time, and same film keep on rotating. It is not like that. Whenever you are clicking our site, the independent session will start for you only, and it will be streamed independently. So this video on demand service we have started, but being it is a independent session based on the viewership and demand, it is available for only registered participant. Now what exactly registered participant we are going to see, but the this service is not free. What we call this kind of services is the value added services. Now with this we have found that only giving the live transmissions and giving the video on demand is not enough, because this is the one way transmission. Either our live transmission or video on demand, it is only a one way transmission. There is no feedback loop from the participant to the transmitting end. So now we were interested in finding out some solution wherein we can achieve some amount of interactivity between the transmitting station and the recipient. Now in this case we have tried to use the Moodle, that is the learning management system which is used in IIT Bombay. So the student who are, again this service is available only to the registered participant, because we cannot allow anybody to enter into the IITB Moodle. So whosoever is a serious participant, they can pay a small amount of fee and then they can become a part of the learning management system. Here they can put their queries, questions, have interaction. There is a provision of a live chatting also, and by this way we have tried to achieve a feedback channel, interactive channel from the remote student to the IITB student and TAs and the faculty also. So the Moodle gives a complete open platform for interaction for all student, teaching assistant and faculty also. Now coming with all these 3-4 solutions, we have come up with a mode of interaction, a model, what we call it as a solo mode. Now solo mode, the free live webcast is available for everybody. You can take a course on live, whereas by paying 1000 rupees per course, you can register as a value added solo mode participant into the CDEEP IIT Bombay. On registration as a participant in the CDEEP IIT Bombay, you will receive a login name and password through which you can access the learning management system of that subject, plus you will access all the courses recorded till that date on the video on demand service. So you will have the facility available video on demand, you will have the facility of learning management system, and you can see the live webcast also. By this way we have come to a model in which you can have access to the IITB courses in a limited interactivity way using the internet. Now the entity in this is the student. We have seen that while using such kind of technique, the individual want to participate, and there are no more solutions available for individual to participate. The name solo has been given to this mode because any individual having an internet connectivity of 100 kbps by paying just 1000 rupees can access to any course in IIT Bombay which is available through CDEEP. So CDEEP makes all their courses available on the webcast. Last semester we have made around 37 courses available, whereas this semester we have made 27 courses available, and number is being varying based on the even or odd semester. To simplify the payment terms also, we have come up with a solution, online payment system. You can visit to the CDEEP site, you can have a choice of the courses available, you can just shop the courses and the bill will be presented to you. You can pay by either MasterCard, Visa card or SBI net banking, and immediately within few seconds you will get a login and password and you can start your learning. Now we just try to compare the satellite courses versus the webcast courses. Now the satellite courses basically required the satellite receiving terminal, whereas webcast courses no extra hardware is required. What is your PC can be used as a your receiving terminal. Second thing is that the cost of hardware, that is the satellite receiving terminal, is huge. So individual or the small organization cannot afford it, whereas in the webcast course you have got just your PC, which is of negligible cost, or by default many people will have. Then the maintenance of SRT is another issue. The geographic limitation, satellite has got its own footprint. So the EduSat what we are using has a footprint of the India and the SAARC countries around. So you can only cater the audience which is situated into the SAARC nations, whereas when we go to the webcast we can cater to the global audience. Then the satellite solution is basically more suitable for the community learning. Group of people will come together having a satellite receiving antenna and screen and everything, and then they can end. Whereas the webcast solution is best or ideal for the individual learning. Then the best part of the satellite technology is that satellite transmission or satellite based education is interactive, whereas in webcast kind of or web based course kind of solution the interactivity is through LMS. So the major issue between the satellite based and the web based education is that in web based education you have got limited interactivity through LMS, whereas on satellite transmission you will have a complete interactive kind of transmission. This is the major difference between two technology. Let's talk about the interactivity. Now the problems with the online interaction and benefits with the LMS. A simple slide I have put. I just want to show you a different angle apart from the satellite, because satellite we are using from last 10 years more or less. So satellite we have done lot of work. Now we are finding out some another option which is cost effective, scalable, global and easily accessible for individualized learning. So here are a few parameters that we would like to discuss the problems with the online interaction. Now what happened with the online interaction? The time is limited. You cannot have unlimited discussion. So if there are 4, 5, 6, 7 centers simultaneously connected, then the time slot or the opportunity given is selective. So basically the online interaction, although it gives us a satisfaction of interactivity, but there is a time limit. There is a selectiveness and limited interaction, because we cannot continue the argument for a longer period. Somewhere we have to stop. Whereas in LMS, if you see, because 2 days you people are going through the Moodle LMS and everything. So I am just not marketing the LMS, but I am seeing the benefit with the LMS is there no time limit. You can access your question at any time. You can generate your query at any time. You can get the answer whenever the person want to give the answer, right? Now multiple queries can be possible. You can ask one question, he will answer, and you can again ask the sub question and again he will answer, and the discussion may go on. So the multiple queries can be generated, multiple solutions can be given. Suppose I put one query and there are 3 people responding me like a blog, wherein you can give the 3 different solutions also. Then the interaction with the teacher, with the fellow student is possible. Now the fellow students interaction was not possible in the satellite communication. Only the teacher is answering the queries. But here in LMS what happened, suppose I am generating one query, a teacher is also answering, a TAs are also answering, maybe a fellow student can also answer. If he has got an answer, he can post his probable solution. So everybody will have an equal chance. Now there is no selectivity. Whosoever have a doubt or query, they can post their question and get the result. So by this way we can justify the LMS based interaction is also another type of interaction wherein one can cater to the problem. Now apart from these live webcast courses or solo courses, we have got another range of solutions available. The other solutions are the screencast. Now what exactly screencast is? There are some subject available wherein we don't want the person to be presented. But we want, suppose I want to teach you Microsoft Office. How come I can teach you how to give the bullet to a particular line? Even if I give a 10 minutes of lecture, you cannot understand. But if I ask you to sit on the machine, see the screen, select this, drag this, drop this, click this and you will get the solution. So basically screens are very important. So we have come up with one solution in which we are only transmitting screens with the audio. So wherein especially this is targeting to the application software based training programs, like for example MATLAB. If you want to learn how to plot a 3D graphs in MATLAB or Scilab, so best way is that you have to transmit the screens only and wherein you can explain on the background. So we have come up with the solution, what we call it as a screencast, which is again very much bandwidth effective. It does not require much bandwidth. So on 36 kbps also we can transmit this screencast on the flash mode. Next is spoken tutorial. We have come up, see, looking to the India as a poor country, we are didn't have a sufficient bandwidth. So we have to find out certain solution which can cater to the general audience. Being our problem is the bandwidth, we should find out certain such type of solutions which can sustain with the lower bandwidth, non-reliable bandwidth. That is why the other solution which is available is the spoken tutorial, in which we may have found that many times I am not needed. My slide and my voice is enough. So why I should project my video? Once you have seen me, that's all, okay. So what we have done in spoken tutorial, the slides and the audio has been modulated together and transmitted. So it requires reasonably less bandwidth than the video, and that can cater to the certain type of subjects very well. We are also streaming Eklavya TV channel. So what, most of the courses, those are being recorded into the NPTEL courses, are being available through the NPTEL TV channel. Now looking into the cable TV operator politics, they didn't stream the Eklavya TV channel through the cable network. Now how to make the cable network available, or how to make the cable TV channel available? What we have done in IIT Bombay, we have put our own disk antenna, we received the channel and we stream it into the campus. You people can also make such kind of efforts in your institute to cater to your student to make the channel available. Then we have started recently, as we are streaming video, we have started, why we don't stream audio only? And we have come up with the audio streaming solution, and we have given the solutions to the student of IIT Bombay. They have started a campus radio. So in which on the internet based web radio, they are transmitting their own programs and making the people aware about the campus activities and the different type of functions and program those are being conducted into the campus. We have also started, Reach Out is our newsletter, in which whatever development we do in the period, we publish it every 2 months. I think this letter, newsletter you are receiving at your institute also, because we send around 5,000 copies free of cost to almost all the engineering colleges and polytechnic colleges in India. Then the live webcast event, be in touch with the IIT Bombay website, whosoever good eminent person those comes to the IIT Bombay for delivering the lectures, most of the lectures are available on the live webcast. So by sitting to your place only, you can also attend the lectures in the IIT Bombay through the live webcast. Now looking ahead, all these things are available. Now the few things those are going to hit very soon. Now the direct to home DTH facility. We have already going through a discussion through the Tata Sky for the making IIT Bombay courses available through the their direct to home service. Whereas now in the mission of education, corridors of learning, Prasar Bharati is giving a dedicated direct to home channel to IIT Bombay to transmit our courses. So it may be now possible that you can have a 2,500 rupees disk antenna at your home and you can see IIT Bombay courses to the direct to home facilities. Maybe we can couple that channel to the DD disk antenna, which is available 1,800 rupees also. Then the IPTV. Now IPTV, we are already started this project with the BSNL Delhi for streaming our courses through the IPTV network. So see, we are trying to cater almost all the types of network which are available for the communication to reach out to the every possible segment of the society. So IPTV, being this is a new technology, basically they are going to launch in 78 metros only in the first plan by the end of this year. BSNL is a service provider. So we have tied up with the BSNL, and maybe by next month IPTV based facility from IIT Bombay will be operational. Then we have already said NKN, that is the National Knowledge Network Terminal in IIT Bombay, wherein all the IITs and all premium institute are connected to the network, through which on HD quality based interactive learning experiment we are going to perform. Already we have got a bilateral pilot project on teaching one course from IIT Bombay to IIT Gandhinagar. Last semester we have tried. Professor Sonuman has delivered that course and it was very successful. In future coming days, we are trying to set up a Wikipedia wherein you can have a courseware of different subject, whereas the virtual laboratories experiments are also under process. So we are trying to find out the solution wherein we will set a laboratory in IIT Bombay that can be actually accessible, the student can do the experiment from the remote station also. So this is all about the different type of services, technologies and that we are trying to incorporate, and we have already executed at IIT Bombay. Virtual lab is a now prematured level. We cannot claim anything, but basically the idea is that virtual lab will be something different than the simulation. It will not be a simulation wherein you can simulate something, get the result. It will be a real kind of thing. For example, let's take, there is a one equipment which is very costly. It is not affordable for every institute to purchase that costly equipment. So the equipment will be available at IIT Bombay, and the control will be given to the some distance participant, and they can perform, they can give the input, they can see the reading from there. If you may have seen the equipment which has been controlled through the web-based control system kind of thing. But those will be basically educational experimental base, not a research. And second thing, the this will be applicable to the specific experiment. It is not possible that the entire IIT Bombay laboratories will be become virtual. So if you go through the IEEE website also, you will find that there are so many papers on virtual laboratories, but every virtual laboratory paper will consist of only one experiment. So it is not a generalized solution, but that is why I told that it is at the prematured level. Once we come up with the solution, we will deliver what exactly we are going to give, but here right now it is a concept, and we have started working also.
In one of the slides you said that some students can pay some amount to IIT and register for a course and access the LMS and other systems.
Right.
So do you have some kind of data on how many students have actually registered?
Yes. There are two separate things. One is the free registration, another is the pay registration. So being we have got a bandwidth crunch, we opened pay registration for only 4 days last semester. So within that 4 days, whosoever are the register are the register participant. When we launch in 2008, the first year we got the register participant 600. So we have reduced our intake capacity because being India, we have got a unicast network available. The bandwidth at the server end is huge. So to regulate that thing, we open it for a very small period at the beginning of the semester, and later on we close the service. Even if today you visit to our site, it will say that it will open at certain date, and on that date only you have to come and register yourself. Okay, thanks.